I welcome all of you once again to my class. My name is Jewel and today I am going to take grammar and this is of class 4. I am dealing with ICSE syllabus Cordova publications. Please like, please share and please subscribe to my channel if you like to hear my further chapters from this textbook. Now let's go to the grammar lesson, nouns. You know that a noun names a person, a place, an animal or a thing. Aranya lives in Chennai. The kitten is playing with my toy. Common nouns are names of people, places, animals or things that are of a general class or kind. So common nouns are the names of people, place, animals or things that are of a class or kind. Example, students, cities, horse, book. Proper nouns are names of a particular person, place, animal or things. Proper nouns means the name of a particular person, place, animal or things, and they begin with capital letters. Rabindranath Tagore, Kochi, Peter Rabbit, Star Wars. The name of the days of the week and the months are also proper nouns. Wednesday and January. In each set, circle the words that are not nouns. First one, cat, aeroplane, eat and Delhi. Eat is not a noun. Second one, Taj Mahal, couple, house, swim. This swim is not a noun. Then number 3, talk, Patna, dog and pen. So talk is not a noun. Number 4, Ritu, Nagaland, slow, telephoned. Here slow is not a noun. Fifth one, Sahil, read, Chandrigar, Premchand. Here read is not a noun. Write suitable common nouns or proper nouns to complete the table. Now common noun and proper noun. City, that is a common noun. Proper noun is New Delhi. Then state is Kerala. Then story is Alice in Wonderland. Then common noun country is, then proper noun is India. Then common noun days means Tuesday, proper noun. Then common noun school. Then what will be the proper noun? It can be Bhavans. Then common noun months, you can write January. Then common noun friend, you can write Ramu, proper noun Ramu. Now circle the proper noun and underline the common nouns in this sentence. First one, my favorite author is J.K. Rowling. So they are telling to circle the proper noun and underline the common noun in the sentence. My favorite author is J.K. Rowling. So J.K. Rowling is the proper noun and the author is the common noun. Second one, the lady is Vanya's mother. So which is the proper noun here? Vanya is the proper noun and mother is the common noun. Third one, Mrs. Iyer is our new neighbor. So Mrs. Iyer is the proper noun and neighbor is the common noun. Fourth one, the new student is from Australia. So Australia is a proper noun and the student is a common noun. Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. So here Mount Everest is the proper noun and peak is the common noun. Sixth one, we went to rock garden in Chandrigar on Monday. So here rock garden, Chandrigar and Monday are proper noun and we are the common noun. Seventh one, July has 31 days. So here July is the proper noun and day is the common noun. Singular nouns refer to only one person, place, animal or thing. Baby, school, puppy, pencil. Plural nouns refer to more than one person, place, animal or thing. So singular noun means only to one person, place, animal or thing. But plural noun means more than one person, place, animal or thing, like babies, schools, puppies, pencils. We can change singular nouns into plural. Now, how will you change singular nouns into plural? We can change singular nouns into plural in different ways by adding S. Understood? By adding S, cat will become cats, cup will become cups. Then, by adding ES to the nouns that end in S, SS, SH, CH and X. Example, bus will become buses, church, churches, box, boxes. By adding ES or S to nouns that end in O, buffalo becomes buffaloes, zoo becomes zoos. By removing Y and adding IES to the nouns that end in Y, for example, city becomes cities, cherry, cherries. By removing F or FE and adding VES to nouns that end in F or FE, calf, calves, knife, knives. Some nouns are spelled differently in their plural forms. Shelf, shelves, foot, feet, man, men. Some nouns remain the same in their singular and plural forms. Deer, deer, sheep, sheep. Now, fill in the blanks with the plural form of the nouns in brackets. So, you have to write the plural form of the nouns, which is this is only singular form. You have to write the plural form of the nouns which are given in brackets. Now, there are dash bracket duck and dash goose in the pond. So, you have to write the plural form. There are ducks and goose will become geese. Plural form of goose is geese in the pond. Second one, there are three dash book and two dash pencil in my bag. So, what is the plural of book? Books. Plural of pencil is pencils. Then, third one, we bought dash apple and dash strawberry from the market. We also got some dash toy for the baby. So, plural of apple is apples. Plural of strawberry is strawberries. The plural form of toy is toys. The dentist checked my dash tooth. What is the plural of tooth? Teeth. Now, there are dash bracket mouse in the storeroom. So, what is the plural form of mouse? Mice. There are mice in the storeroom. Now, look at the picture and answer the questions. How many apples are there in the basket? Can you count the juice in the jug? Can you count the rice in the bowl? Now, we can count some common nouns. They are known as countable nouns. So, the nouns which you can count, they are called countable nouns. Now, there are 9 apples in the basket. Many children are taking part in the play. Then, we cannot count some other nouns. Some nouns we cannot count. They are known as uncountable nouns. So, nouns which we cannot count are called uncountable nouns. There is no water in the tank. Can you count water? No. So, there is no water in the tank. Please don't put sugar in the milk. So, these nouns are uncountable nouns. Nouns like water and sugar. It is uncountable nouns. Now, circle the uncountable nouns in each set. So, in this, you have to circle which is the uncountable nouns in each sentence. First one, juice. Can you count juice? No, you cannot count juice. So, juice is the uncountable nouns. Bicycle and puppy and house, you can count, but juice you cannot count. Second one, book, car, sand, lamb. Here, which is uncountable, which you cannot count? Sand. Sand, it is difficult to count. It is uncountable noun. Third one, chair, floor, baby, pen. Can you count the floor? No, you cannot count the floor. So, it is uncountable noun. Fourth one, table, plate, sugar, shoes. So which is the uncountable noun? Sugar. Sugar we cannot count. So it is uncountable noun. Now, fifth one, cat, water, ball, kite. So which is the uncountable noun here? Water. Can you count water? No. So it is an uncountable noun. Now, nouns that name males of persons or animals are of the masculine gender. So, masculine means what? The males of persons, or it can be male of person or it can be of animal. Both males of person or animal are called masculine gender. Boy, brother, king, tiger. So, all these are males. Nouns that name females of person or animals are of the feminine gender. No, females of persons or animals are called feminine gender. Example, girl, sister, queen, tigress. Now, nouns that name both males and females are of the common gender. So, there are nouns that name both males and female. They are called common gender nouns. Example, cousin, teacher, friend, neighbor. Now, nouns that name neither males nor females are of the neuter gender. So, there are some nouns which are neither male. That means they are not male nor female. There are nouns which are not male nor female. And these type of nouns are called neuter gender. Example, bag, shoe, ball, phone. Now, to write masculine, feminine, common or neuter for these nouns. Father. Father is what? It is a boy. No, father. So, it is masculine gender. Baby. Baby is what? Baby is a common gender. Then, lamb. Lamb is neuter gender. House is also a neuter gender. Then, mother. Mother is a feminine gender. Uncle. Uncle is masculine gender. Teacher. Teacher is common gender. Aunt. Aunt is common gender. Ninth one, nephew. Nephew is common gender. Peahen. Peahen is feminine gender. Doctor. Doctor is common gender. Pot. Pot means neuter gender. Now, change the underlined nouns into the opposite gender and rewrite the sentence. So, what they are saying? They are saying to change the underlined noun. See, woman, in the first sentence, woman and queen has been underlined. So, what you have to do is to change the underlined nouns to their opposite gender. You have to write the opposite of the opposite gender of these two words. Write the opposite gender of the underlined words. Okay. First one, the old woman advised the queen. So, here in the sentence, the old woman will become man. Woman will change into man. It is the opposite gender of woman is man. Advise the queen. Advise the queen will become king. Understood? Queen will change into king. Now, second one, my father and his brother are twins. So, here father, how will you change father? Father will become mother. My mother and his brother. Brother will become what? Brother will change to sister. So, my mother and his sister are twins. Now, third one, my mother's grandfather. So, how will you change the gender? Mother will become father. My father's grandfather will become grandmother. Was a famous poet. Now, fourth one, my uncle has 2 cows and 6 ducks on his farm. So, yeah, my uncle. Uncle will change into aunt. Opposite gender of uncle is aunt. Has 2 cows. What is the opposite gender of cows? Ox. And 6 ducks. Ducks will change into drake. Drake. D-R-A-K-E. Drake on his farm. Now next one. Fifth one. The policeman helped the old lady to cross the road. So, the opposite gender of policeman is what? Police woman. So, the police woman helped the old lady. Lady will change to gentleman. Lady will change to gentleman. Cross the road. So, the police woman helped the old gentleman to cross the road. Now, next is a noun used to name a group of persons, animals or things is called collective noun. For example, a team of players, a bunch of grapes, a flock of birds. Now, fill in the blanks with the collective nouns from the box. Answers, collective nouns are given in the box. Band, range, gang, fleet, panel, set and crowd. So now I am going to read a paragraph. So we have to write the collective noun from the box. Now, today we celebrated annual day at our school. First, a band of musicians performed on stage. Next, the principal honored a student who saved a man from being robbed by a gang of thieves. The student received a set of books. Then the principal announced that it was time for lunch. I saw that a crowd of people had gathered outside the auditorium. The hall was decorated with photographs clipped by the students from the photography club. A panel of judges selected a picture of a fleet of ships and another one showing a range of mountains as the best photographs of the lot. Now, a possessive noun shows that something belongs to someone. So, possessive noun shows that something belongs to someone. To take the possessive form of a singular noun, use an apostrophe and the letter S. The apostrophe comes after the noun and before the S. Anu's car. The car belonging to Anu. The baby's toy. The toy belonging to the baby. Now, if a singular noun ends in S, use the apostrophe and the letter S after the noun. Now, Suhas. Apostrophe S, bag. That is the bag belonging to Suhas. Jess, speech. The speech given by Jess. Now, next one. For the possessive form of a plural noun, use the apostrophe after the noun. The teacher's room. That is the room of the teachers. So they are saying that if the possessive form is in the plural, if the possessive form of a plural noun, you have to use the apostrophe after the noun. For example, the teacher's room, the room of the teachers, the dog's bowls, the bowls of the dogs. If a plural noun does not end in an S, we use the apostrophe and S. Men's clothes, the clothes of the men. Children's books, books of the children. Then, add apostrophes where needed and rewrite the sentence. We are going to Amman's birthday party. So, you have to put apostrophe. That is what they are telling to put apostrophe. We are going to Amman's, A-M-A-N apostrophe as Amman's birthday party. Now, second one. My mother's sari is made of silk. So, where you should put apostrophe? My mother's. So, M-O-T-H-E-R apostrophe S. Mother's sari is made of silk. Full stop. Third one. The peacock's feathers are so colorful. So, that peacock's. Peacock's. So, P-A-C-O-C-K apostrophe S. Peacock's feathers are so colorful. Fourth one. My parents' wedding anniversary is tomorrow. So you must write my parents, P-A-R-E-N-T apostrophe S. Parents' wedding anniversary is tomorrow. Then fifth one, this is Sanjay's room. So this is Sanjay's. So S-A-N-J-A-Y apostrophe S, Sanjay's room. Sixth one, the teacher checked the students' notebooks. So where to put apostrophe? The teacher checked the students'. S-T-U-D-E-N-T apostrophe S, students, notebooks. Now, in each sentence, if the possessive pronoun is noun is used correctly, put a tick. If it is incorrect, write it correctly. Sheep's wool is used to make sweaters. Sheep's, S-H-E-E-P apostrophe S. Now, second one, these bats are for the girls' cricket team. Your girls, G-I-R-L apostrophe S. Now, Salma's aunt is my teacher. Salma's, S-A-L-M-A apostrophe S. Fourth one, this is Mrs. Sen's car. So sense, S-E-N apostrophe S. Fifth one, this is my grandmother's purse. So grandmother's, G-R-A-N-D-M-O-T-H-E-R apostrophe S. Okay children, I hope you all understood the grammar section of this lesson. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Please send your comments and please give a like if you like my teaching. Okay children, I'll meet you in the next class. Until then, bye.